Erika Jo Brown is from New York. She most recently lived in Georgia, where she taught at Savannah State University and co-curated the Seersucker Shots reading series. Her debut poetry collection, I'm Your Huckleberry, will be released by Brooklyn Arts Press in November. So, Erika.
I'm gonna try to get that image of the dead dog out of your head. I'm trying to get it out of my head. I'm gonna talk to Will later about that. I think he left because he has class. I'm delighted to see you here, but now I feel so sad. All right, this one's called You'd Better, and it's EWE because I'm gonna do that right now. All right. Come smoke my superb sheep herb. But what about your husbandry? And why were wizened white men so fetishistic about shepherds anyway, with their calendars and vergers and nymphs? And have you heard? Bird is a word? Among the glebes and lees, feathered, winged, and bipedal, I mean waterfowl, plover, and petrels? In taxonomic language, nightjars are rendered caprimulgiforms, rendered with butter in Francoise Creole chicken kitchen. Folkloric nightjars are crepuscular goat suckers, chloroforming Billy Capra, doing their untoward dances undeterred. Goats browse while sheep prefer clover. Sheep's keep a stiff upper lip, split by a groove. Groove is in the heart, undergirded by tabacchi. What the flock has happened to this fursome cur? Do you smell the distinctly nutty rutting odors? And how many sheps do we have to herd? Thanks. That's that one. All right. I do talk about animals a lot. And botany. Any other questions you can ask me? This one's just called Vermont. This spring, I've seen several allium, alley-oop, bright bulbous balls of stupid, a pungent purple stalking the onion family. My father taught me about all the flowering things. Alfalfa is chlorophyll. Seaweed is chloroform. Your childhood was so weird. So much separates us, vocabulary, horticulture experiences, dietary adherences, that it's a wonder, it's a wonder, it's a wonder, crumb bun, the connections in our craniums, in our respective green thumbs, oh, Jamaican rum, rum. Listen, we know whatever will come will grow, whatever will come, pond scum, art gum, the common plum, will have to connect and with cellular moxie. How's everybody feeling? Okay. All right, I got three more. You can start the countdown. Violet is a lady, this is a long title. Violet is a lady plant whose need for rain and sun reigns violently. See, Violet, the lady plant, prefers simplicity, the vinaigrette, the matching of components indivisible and weak, like starlings and sky, the villainous sky towards which she reaches. Vinyasana helps. She vibrates when her little eyelet feels overly pliant. She fancies herself a Vidalia onion, aguing a vindaloo stew or a nice vichyssoise on her good days. Those inviolate good days when she doesn't feel vicarious, an invalid, invalid, a victim, when mundane items, a hydrant, for instance, resist becoming something violent, a trident, with evil intent, for instance. Mightn't she enjoy pollen riven by the gem cutter above? Things as themselves, angular, faceted, sugar, sweet Guadalupe, vile vines creep round her planty mind. And then I put the dictionary down for a little bit and did these other ones. This is my political poem. I like my history movies with reenactments and my science with CGI because I want it that way. Tell me why, mollusk, musky, loaf, and lean, observing a blade of summer seaweed when there are rock lobsters endangered in coastal waterways. Don't be so shellfish. I wear my heart on the sleeve of my exoskeleton. I'm all inside out about it. I'm not one to make macro critiques, but when you post upworthy videos without revealing the punchline, then you are contributing to the clickbait problem. Aquaculture is the wave of the future. Over 40% of humans rely on the sea as their main source of protein. I'm allergic to self-pity, but I eat it all the time. You're so fresh, so protean, you salty bivalve. Urchin of the sea, but a freak in the sheets. Due to stylish consumption of oysters and other factors, more and more people are moving seaward. Soon, only Iowa will be left. Mussels with heavy metal content. Prawns of arsenic, embrace me with your thousand claws. Tell me I'll never be lonely again. Don't pollute the ocean, guys. Here's the last one. All right, here's the last one. I stole the title from a gardening catalog. Beds I Have Known. I was like, is she kidding? That's amazing. Gardening. Beds I Have Known. Okra, we didn't know what to do with. And tomatoes in their vegetal variety, like their wintry opposite, like berries in the holly, a cardinal in snow. The corn was a joke, erect as soldiers with fruit sprouting crazily from their elbows. We had farm parties, farmers' almanacs, and hand-hewn A-frames, some frondescence out of lexicon, a berry briar, an herb wheel, a mint plot heathered with honeybees and intrigue. And the wildflowers, homeless, painted, clumped up by the entrance, out of bounds, tiger lily, sweet pea, buttercup, and how we loved them. Thanks, y'all.